And you're very welcome back. Women's singles time once again. Taking to the court, Scotland's Kirsty Gilmour against Rong SCHAFER of the USA, formerly Rong Bo, of course, of China. And you can see the matches that have gone before us. If you're just joining us, Wang beat Fleming Kwok, Jacquet victorious over Holly Newell. And just a few moments ago, Thanapat Pistopong beating Martina Rapishka in two games. So Kirsty Gilmour back in the arena that holds many, many memories for Kirsty. Runner-up here, of course, last year to Carolina Marin, who went on, of course, to win the World Championship only a few months ago. And had such a wonderful experience here during the summer, of course, the Emirates Arena hosting the Badminton Tournament for the Commonwealth Games. And all been positive experiences, really, for Kirsty. And she's taken a little bit of time out since. I think went on a holiday and just took a break from the game and back again and refocus. I know she's going off soon to Asia to play the Axiata Cup, along with half the Scottish team, I think. But this one, a tough test, because I know Rong Bo, Rong SCHAFER, as she is now, and has the quality, those Chinese qualities, to really trouble Kirsty if Kirsty is not at her best.
Yeah, and I'm looking forward to this, Mark. I think she will be at her best. I think that the rest has done her good. The last time I saw her, I thought she looked lethargic. That was in the final. I think her focus was wrong on the day. She was focused on what she had achieved, not what she could achieve. And I think she's out here focused on what she can achieve. And once again, we're going to see a girl that's hungry. She's going to be up for anything that comes her way. And I would expect her to win this. It won't be easy. No Chinese player is easy to beat. But I expect her to play well. And she does like this arena.
Yeah, she looked like she settled for that silver against Michelle Lee in that Commonwealth match. And really looked out of sorts. Like, you know, it was just one match too far for her.
Yeah, and it's difficult, especially in front of your home crowd in the Commonwealth Games. And people who don't understand the Commonwealth Games or have never taken part in it, some people laugh at it. It's a tough thing, and especially at a home games, there's so much pressure on you. And there are quality players, real quality players in that field.
Rong SCHAFER,
and
USA.
She performed exceptionally well throughout
on
the 10
left,
days.
Kirsty
and
Gilmour,
then to
Scotland.
Win a silver medal, did very well. I was slightly disappointed because I felt she could have given a better account of herself.
Play.
But she was very tired on that morning.
Yeah, I think I remember speaking to her not so long after, just an idle chat online, and she was telling me she didn't even sleep that night before and came to the court drained.
Yes, and it's the emotion of everything when you've done something no one in your country's done before. But and it's a little bit of the Scottish mentality. It's not been focused on the big prize, because I believe she was good enough, but on the day she was found wanting. But we're back here now, and she's out there, and I'm sure she'll play very, very well. She's looking very quick at the moment.
She's no head-to-head between these. They haven't played each other, but Rong SCHAFER, certainly familiar with European style of play, spent a couple of years in Denmark playing club badminton in Denmark. I think it was either in Aarhus or Aalborg, and moved to the USA in the recent past. Is married now, of course, with American citizenship. And some good players in America going to battle it out for spotted the Olympics.
One,
oh, the big Olympics circus starts in May when the qualification starts. You've got Zhang Bei-Win, who's a former Chinese, who went through Singapore and has ended up in Los Angeles, now playing for America, and is now inside the world's top 10. And, you know, you've got some quality coming from that side of the pond, albeit in a roundabout direction from China originally. Nice backhand block from Rong.
I'll tell you, I'm definitely wrong. because I watched her in the first few rallies, and I think you heard me say that Kirsty looked very quick. I don't think the girl had got into gear at all, and watching her in that rally, she looked very, very quick as well, so it's maybe going to be a lot tougher for Kirsty than I thought.
In a short space of time, Rong SCHAFER has really climbed up the world rankings.
So it's over. Four.
In something 8 or 9 months, come up from outside the world's top 500, inside the world's top 50.
This is a lovely shot here. That beautiful reverse. Yeah. Beautiful reverse, fast cross-court cut. And it has to be fast. You get the deception because people are worried about the straight clear and the straight... the straight clear and the straight smash. So they're leaning on that, and you hit a fast cross cut. You need to be an exceptional player to get a very good one of those back. But this is, it's going to be a very tight game, I think.
Yeah, in a different level and a different quality to the badminton we saw, say, for example, in the previous match.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, nice little stop net shot from Gilmour.
Six.
See, you get that deception by having your racket out early, taking the shuttle early. The shuttle's coming to the racket, and you just do a double action. Put it over the net, and it was a winner there.
Straight smash down the line from Rong.
So it's over. Four.
No, you were right, Mark. It was a straight smash down the line.
Yeah. Same thing twice. Four matches in and I'm already...
That's because two wrongs don't make a right. That was unlucky there.
So it's over.
From Rong there. It was a nice shot she was trying to play. Kirsty will have to work for this.
Yeah, it's certainly a tough match. It's your opening match. You would like something a little bit easier. But Kirsty would have certainly done her homework on Rong. And the speed of the shots that Kirsty played, you know, it's certainly something that has improved in the last number of years. Like, I remember Kirsty playing in, say, European Juniors, the year Carolina Marin won the European Juniors, beating Beatrice Corrales in the final. And Kirsty was nowhere, you know, she was completely off the pace. And it just shows you how much, you know, if you work hard and you really, really want it, how, you know, how good you really can become, especially in women's singles, you get somebody who can work hard.
Absolutely, yeah. And that's what I was meaning about Sabrina Jacque. She's a very good player, but she doesn't really have weapons that will hurt you. But she's worked very hard at her game, consistency and movement around the court, covers the court very well. But I think this is a level up from that now that we're watching.
Oh, that's right in the corner.
So it's over.
And once again, it's a good shot because it's hitting firmly into the corner, but into the drift.
It's always a good sign with Kirsty also when you get the little bit of vocal exercise after a point. You know she's up for it.
So it's over. Six.
When she's pushed flat into that round ahead, that's two mistakes she's made there. I hope it's just a little blip and it's not something we're going to see from her here today.
It's Service fault call. Service over.
Service fault called. I think, yes, six. Service called against wrong ball. Oh, it's Elaine Bankier is on the chair. Nice net from Gilmour. Yeah, good vision from Rong SCHAFER.
Well, it was very good, Mark, because I thought she was shaping up to hit a smash there, and but Bo read it beautifully and took it early. I was very impressed with that.
Service over, 11-7.
Yeah, frustration interval from Rong. Has not quite realised at the interval yet. Suddenly she realises and marches to her box, but it's the interval lead. More and Yvette, as always, in Kirsty's corner. Man, they've been together a few number of years now, and Yvette has done wonders really with Kirsty. How long has she been in Scotland now, Dan?
4 years. Four years with her. And as you say, at the European Juniors, you know, Kirsty didn't medal at all. And Carolina Marin and Beatrice Corrales were gold and silver. But Kirsty's worked her socks off since then, and Yvette's been a major part of that.
Yeah, Kirsty beaten in the second round in that European Juniors. But that's history. That was 2011. We're now fully fledged senior player with a senior attitude and a senior way of going about our business. And the big, long, loopy forehand serve. It gets more loopy every time I see it.
Well, that's the one thing I don't like about watching her. I hate the way she does that at the start of her serve. I don't know where she got that from. It just appeared all of a sudden.
Yeah, because I remember I was at the Czech International in 2012 when Kirsty got her first international win, and she won in Poland the week before that, an international series. And then all of a sudden, a few weeks later, this the big loopy serve appeared, and I had no idea where it came from.
12.
But if she's happy with it, that's the main thing, and if it does the business for her, and she does hit a very good serve with it, so who are we to say it's wrong? But that was a fantastic rally. I don't know how many strokes. I actually think that was in. I thought it was a lovely slow drop when she played it, but I think that was a poor call there. Yeah, and that's you can see the experience of Rong there. Kirsty, when she hit that fast cross reverse from round the head earlier in the game, Rong was nowhere near it. Now she read it and took it early. And that's what you're dealing with, the exposure these Chinese athletes get when they're young. You may catch them once or twice, but you better be on the ball. And Kirsty's up for it there. That was very quick and very
13,
good.
8.
...13-8 advantage for the top seed, Kirsty Gilmour. Back in the arena where she won the silver. And just even the announcement that the Worlds will be coming here in 2017...
14,
...already
eight.
Players like Gilmour will be formulate plans to be ready for that. Little matter of the Olympics before that, of course. Yeah. Always interesting for me as an outsider, Dan, you know, you see the situation when you go to the Olympics. It's Great Britain, obviously, and generally You must be in Milton Keynes in the GB National Centre to be selected. Not necessarily you can qualify, but you still have to be selected, you know, by your home nation.
It's over. Nine.
She has spent some time in Milton Keynes, but now she's back up here, obviously. Certainly was short term for the Commonwealths. And what can be her plan, or what will be the plan moving forward?
In very few words, I don't know. I apologise to everyone for that, but I don't know what's going to happen.
Probably only one person that knows that right now. That's the player herself. But it's certainly going to be interesting to see how that one unfolds.
I'm sure GB will want her to be a part of things.
Yeah, of course they will, yeah.
So it's over. 15.
And you could certainly have got a lot easier Nine. First rounds than this one. She's having to play exceptionally well here. This girl's a very good player indeed.
Still, it's a focused start from Gilmour. You know, she's come out of the blocks quite well. She got into that 3-love lead, okay. Rong SCHAFER did level it up at 3-all, but it's Gilmour who's still in the ascendancy, leading 15-9. That's quick feed forward.
So it's over.
From Rong.
10, 15.
And very clever play from her as well. Playing the net shot and then looking for the net reply.
Yeah, just a little bit slow getting up
11,
for the net spin.
15.
Just seemed to be a little bit far away from it when she was addressing the shuttle.
That's just the drift there, you could see just affecting the shuttle, taking it. It was going out, but it went further out.
Oof. Very poor serve from Rong, and she certainly got away with it. Yeah.
She did. And she's very much back in this now.
12, 15.
Very, very good play from Kirsty there.
So it's over.
Using the court 16, well, and then getting 12. The chance, taking the opportunity to smash and come in and look for the reply. Here you see it here, very quick forward, jump in. That was very good indeed.
Message coming in from the University of Birmingham, wishing their player, of course the National Badminton League, University of Birmingham, a part of the new National Badminton League down in England, wishing their player Heather Oliver all the best in the Scottish Open Women's Doubles. 12. I think the National Badminton League returns on the 1st of December. And after it, a little bit of a scare. Gilmour has seized the initiative once again.
18, 12.
Yeah, and Rong has played a couple of very loose shots. She played an unforced error off serve and a very flat and short clear there. Just too eager there, Kirsty. Just needs to be a little
13,
bit more patient. She's quick
18.
Enough.
that looked to be going out. And in the end, I think justice may be done.
14, 18.
Straight smash, landing out. 2 points in a row for Rong. This one I thought was drifting out. Ooh, may have cut the line.
That was definitely going out. Yeah. Definitely.
Oh, that's a wild swing.
That was very 18. Loose from Kirsty.
18.
But you see the difference in tempo there. Rong was very, very quick on her feet. Putting Kirsty under a lot of pressure and forcing that error there. But it was a very bad error. Rong's making a big push to get back in this game here.
Beautiful drop from Gilmour. Oh, pinpoint accuracy in the deep forehand corner.
19, 15.
All set up by that attacking drop that she played midway through during the rally.
Play on, please.
There's that drop again from Gilmour.
20.
Takes the Scot and the top seed to 15. Game point. Three rallies in a row. She's used that drop effectively and following up very quick at the net for the kill and win it the first game, 21-15. But she was made work hard in that game, Dan.
Yeah, but this is it's the type of game you want early in a competition, as long as you know you're good enough to win it, because it's going to make you work hard. It's going to keep your level up, keep you moving fast and thinking quick. And that's what she's having to do here. You can play players and you have an easy first round or an easy second, and you don't know, you're not up for the games when they come. But if you can keep this level and keep your performance up there, we've seen games around the hall this morning where there's quality players dropping sets against players they shouldn't, and that's because they let their quality fall. Kirsty can't afford to do that here. She's got to keep her game at a very high level. And that's the way you want to do it, as long as you're not going to three sets and taking too much physically out of yourself. So here's hoping she doesn't go to three sets and take too much out herself.
Now, I think while it's a real test, she has all the shots in her locker. On Kirsty's right shoulder, the logo of Sullybad, of course. Sullybad, the charity based in France, run by Raphael Sacheton of Badminton Photo.
20 seconds.
Of course, who've recently signed the Sullybad Charter, as well as many federations, and doing great things for underprivileged nations and underprivileged children, getting them to play badminton projects. Gathering up millions of racquets and euros and bringing it out and setting up academies and things like that. And a lot of the players now also supporting that charity.
Second game. Level. Play.
It was good to see Rong giving herself a little pep talk there in the break. No coach here to help her. And just a nod of approval at the end. And that's what Kirsty has to watch now. She's hitting with the drift behind her and just overcooking that lift there and putting it out the back.
Yeah, Rong, for all the time she spent in Europe, in Denmark, always travelled alone and without a coach, so she's well used to flying solo.
One, all.
Here we see Kirsty jumping very quick onto the shuttle. Lovely cross. Rong just putting it on the wrong side of the line.
And the short backhand lift, easy for Gilmour.
One.
That's another lift out.
Two.
So Kirsty will need to be careful with that.
Yeah, of course, Kirsty, as you said, Dan, playing with the wind in her back almost in this second game.
Three, two.
Beautiful cross net, and she liked that one.
That was a lovely shot. I think she might have been luckier earlier in the rally with her lift. I think her lift was going out and Rong hit it. The very first lift that she put in round the head.
Forced to hang in there in that rally, Dan. But coming out on the right side of it in the end, Gilmour fighting and stretching for every shot in the rally.
Well, the drift is against it here, so if it was any
indecision from the line judge and then the umpire.
The umpire's overruled, yes. It did look in. It did look in.
Certainly inside the line. And short serve from Rong.
Service over. Five.
The thing I like here is Kirsty's playing more net off serve so that she's not having to lift the shuttle the way she was at the start of the set.
Certainly not the most powerful smash in the world from Rong SCHAFER.
Yeah, it's not. I was going to say that earlier, and I forgot to. When she had a chance and she hit a smash and came in, and she chose the wrong option after it. But it was the lack of power in it. It's a nice crisp hit, but she doesn't look to put a great deal of body turn into it or anything. But I think if Kirsty's going to win comfortably here, she has to be attacking more than she is. I think if she attacks the girl, she'll win comfortably. But if she allows the girl to come on to her, I think she's going to be in a dogfight. She's got to remember the drift in the hall. She's got to remember even when you're under pressure, that's what separates the world-class players from people would say the also-rans or the others. It's coping with the drift, coping with conditions and the pressure of the game you're in.
Service over.
Tight second game, this.
Six.
Pretty much point for point.
You see Rong just looking at the back of the court there. I think she was wondering if it had been in, if she'd left it or whatever, but she tried to play it.
Oh. Easy winner for Rong.
It's over.
Yeah, but I think she mistimed it, Mark. I think she did.
It certainly didn't come off the sweet spot. Mm.
It's a silly mistake there.
Eight, seven.
Unforced error.
Rong certainly has a nice range of shots, but it's when it's that smash that just lacks the power.
Mm-hmm. She's a lovely mover. She's very quick on her feet, but the thing that's impressing me about Kirsty there is her movement. As you were saying, Rong's got a lot of strokes in her locker. Lovely movement as well, but Kirsty's coping with it. And I thought Rong played a lovely shot, but Kirsty read it beautifully and then put Rong under pressure. And about four shots later, she made the mistake.
Service over. 8-9.
So it's still anybody's game here. As I said earlier, I think Kirsty has to try and keep the attack when she can.
She did everything right, Dan.
Yep.
Good.
9-0.
She did everything right except the very last shot there. She was just a fraction late on it, and it was just too tight at the net, and she hit it into the net. She would have been better. Obviously, it's easy sitting here, but playing a net shot when you realise that you can't kill it.
Yeah, there was plenty of venom on the smash, and you know, the footwork was right, she was coming forward. But as you said, probably the net shot would have been the wise option.
Service over, 10-9.
And Rong just snatching there at that shot, just making a very silly mistake.
In, and even if it wasn't in, it clipped Kirsty's foot before it even hit the ground, so technically a foul. So 10-0, and as you mentioned the phrase dogfight, and it's certainly turning into that right now.
Well, it's going to be very, very tough. This girl's good.
It's a good stretch and good recovery from Rong. Yeah, and a good rally from the American.
11-10, interval.
And it's she who gets into the interval with that slender one-point advantage, and a nice way to go into it with a rally like that. Made to work really hard. And Yvette just really trying to get her point across to Kirsty.
Yeah, but there, Kirsty, you saw in the replay there that Kirsty moving off the shuttle as she tried to play
it.
Just making the mistake instead of having her weight going forward. She was trying to be deceptive, but it's very difficult when you take your weight out of a shot. You've got to put more into
one,
the racket head then
seconds.
On got connection one, with the shuttle.
20 seconds.
But Yvette will be telling her just to up the pace, try and take it early at the front, get the attack. I think if she attacks this girl, she will win.
Play.
Oh, beautiful net from Gilmour. Really tight spinning net shot.
So it's over.
I think 11, the shuttle was still in its spin when Rong had to address it and trying the cross court net. The only thing she could really do, of course, we'll see it here again on the replay. Beautiful control. Yeah, it wasn't a million miles out either.
But that rally would take a lot out of Rong.
Play on, please, ladies.
Kirsty came forward at one point in it with a racket up and played a net shot, and Rong had to push off and do a very deep lunge. That's the type of movement that taxes you.
12, 11.
But Kirsty's back in front again, so hopefully she'll remain that way for the rest of the game.
34 minutes gone. Kirsty Gilmour winning the first 21-15. Single point advantage here in the second. From both girls. And in the end, the error from Gilmour.
Service over.
You can see Rong hadn't got much left in that rally. Running out of steam by the end of it.
And this is where the psychology comes in. Kirsty's to win 9 points. Rong knows if she wins the 9 points from here, she's got another game to go. And it can be in the back of your mind because it's a tough battle at the moment. And is she up for another full set of this if she's to secure this set?
Perfect from Rong, right on the line.
13.
Kirsty having a look at the umpire again, but I don't think she can have any qualms with that decision.
No, it was a very nice shot. Here you come, see it, just a lovely cut, soft cut cross court.
Yeah, right on the line. Gilmour really dealing very easily with those smashes.
Service over. 13.
And that's the thing, she's a lovely player, but she doesn't have... Kirsty's got nothing to worry about giving her the shuttle in the air. Yes, she's going to hit accurate shots, but as long as you're fit enough to keep running and keep getting them back, you're going to force her into a position where she'll try something and possibly make a mistake, or you get the chance to attack her. And I think Kirsty overhead's got more power than she has.
Yeah, for sure. And you can see Kirsty persisting with the high serve. Nothing to fear from the high serve, really.
Yes!
Oh, that was just out.
Yeah, I think it was out.
I'm right on that line, and that was out.
She's just trying to hope it was in and maybe influence the line judge by shouting, but it was out.
14, 13.
See, Rong's feeling it. You can see the amount of time she's taking in between points to compose herself. Kirsty's feeling it too, but she's got a set in the bag, so it's not so much a mental struggle for her.
Oh, good play.
Yeah, she's got lovely shots, lovely crisp shot strokes, very accurate, and a lovely control and defence there.
It's over. 15-14.
In this second game, there's never been more than 2 points between the players. 37 minutes gone. Going for the wrong shot there, Dan.
Yeah, so definitely. She should just have lifted and got her back working again. Get into the rally. That was very, very, very silly there from Kirsty. I've never lost a game sitting watching. Make all the right choices when I'm sitting down. But it's tough. Can see Rong composing herself. The length of time she's taking in between points is a lot longer than it was at the start of the game. That's a bad smash 16, from Kirsty with the drift 15. Going across left to right as she's hitting. Just has to bring her margin for error in slightly on that side when she's hitting smashes.
Good execution on the return of serve from Gilmour.
Oof. Oh, that was well done from Kirsty. She covered a lot of court there. Three or four full diagonals covered. It was very good stroke play from Rong.
She just hung in there, Dan, in that rally, and it just shows you there's an example. Any kids that are watching, you just keep running and get something back on it. You never know what can happen.
Absolutely, and that's what Holly could learn from watching someone like Kirsty here. It's a bad smash from Rong there to miss that.
Yeah, it's probably the weakest point of her game.
Yeah, that is the pressure because she's getting opportunities, but she's not getting through the defence of Gilmour with her smash. And she's not really forcing Kirsty to play poor replies from it. So she's having to work very hard and be very accurate with her strokes and just trying to go too close to the line with the smash.
And moving Gilmour around. A lot of court being covered by both players. Oh, some quality shots. Whoa, what a backhand. Oh, probably the best rally of the match so far. And then Gilmour at full stretch and out on the floor. and the crowd get involved and they like that. But really, top class rally from both girls.
Yeah. Absolutely, some superb stroke play there. But you'll see they're all over the place. And that was a very good pickup from Kirsty. But worried about getting flicked to the rear of the court again. But that's it. Watching the girl Rong play, that's the way she would have to play against anybody that's world class. They would be long rallies because she doesn't have the power to hit through them or to force a weak reply where you can hit the winner from the forecourt. But all credit to her, she's stuck to this task and she's in with a chance.
Kirsty just making sure she stayed on the ground long enough to get some sweat down and get some valuable extra seconds to recover while the mopper is on the court.
Thank you.
Yeah, I don't know how Rong is feeling at this moment in time, but if I was Rong, I would be standing on the court.
Dan, you're always wrong.
Yes, you sound like my wife. I'm never right. But if I was Rong, I would be out there now trying to force Kirsty to get back on that court as quick as possible. Because Rong will be tired, but that rally took a lot out of Kirsty. She was all over the place there, retrieving shuttles and then eventually diving for one. No silly mistakes now. Focus.
So it's over. To me, that was out again. Line, and I can understand the frustration from Rong. Crucial points.
Rong's not happy.
No, she's saying is at least
she may well be right.
I'm not sure if we're going to get a replay in this.
Is Rong right?
A little bit late on the replay.
Well, that may well be it.
Yeah, that was a big point.
19, yes.
17. Yeah.
Put a little bit of light between Gilmour and Rong.
So that call will play in her mind a little, but it was right on the wrong line.
And really, this is a must-win point from an American's perspective. Certainly count herself unlucky.
20.
Miss Gilmour goes to 17. Match point 21-17.
And Rong is not happy there.
And a controversial line call on the umpire's side. May prove decisive. And because Kirsty wants to get on with this, she's back out, she's ready to serve, waiting for Rong. In the end, easy jump smash, fist pumps the air. A difficult match, Dan, and she's come through it, and she's come through it pretty well in the end. It was always going to be a tough one against Rong SCHAFER. Yeah, and she's still not happy. Look, still arguing the case, and she certainly has a valid argument. I certainly thought it was out. But those things tend to balance themselves out in matches anyway. You win some, you lose some. But in the end, Kirsty Gilmour seemed very focused and finishing it off with that powerful jump smash. Value for the win?
Absolutely. It was a very tight call. It looked to us as if it may just have been out. But she lost to 17. So I know it's a big thing psychologically, and it was at the time. It was a very tight call. But I'm sure the line judge didn't do it on purpose. They're very fair here. He's calling it as he sees it. But she feels she got a bad call there.
Yes, both players leave the court. Again, warm round of applause from Gilmour, from the crowd. Really the crowd's favourite, Kirsty Gilmour. They love her here. And Rong Bo can probably count herself a little bit unlucky, but certainly played a good match against the top seed. And what was a tough match for Kirsty Gilmour. We pan out wide. We can see the glory of the Emirates Arena.